Greetings and welcome to week four of CS 295. We are going to be using PHP to access data, aka using forms. So the first lesson we're going to do is setting up a form, and then we'll go into gets and post after that. But to kind of look at the code first, you can see down here that we're using the forms. Now, when we're just learning the basics of JavaScript, if you used a form and you were trying to do JavaScript without pausing that form, you'd have issues. But now we actually want to use these forms, right? But you also notice that the form has some extra information in it. We'll talk about when to use what, but for now, the key is using this form tag and then these input tags. So let's go ahead and jump into kind of putting this all together. So I've already created a PHP file called form.php. So whatever you're using to do this, there's a webhost, WAMP, LAMP, you're going to go ahead and get your basic HTML set up, and then we're going to add our form tag, right? So you have the form tag. You've probably seen this before. Basically, what you're going to do is the tags that you're putting in here is the information that you are going to send across to the server. So remember, as a reminder, what we're doing, HTML, JavaScript all runs on your PC. We need to get the information to a server where it can process it, do whatever it needs to do, log in, update stuff. And this is kind of where it starts, with a form. Now there's two pieces that you need. Again, I'm just really teaching you the bare minimum to get this to work, right? So there's much more to this, but this is kind of how this works. So you need the action, right? And this is a piece that we need, and then we also need the method. All right, so these are attributes for form. Right now, the default action is to go ahead and load the same page, and we'll talk about what that means when we get to it working. Again, this is just getting the form set up. Right, so we have the action. This is what page it's going to go to send the data to. And as we start seeing the gets and the post later on in this lesson, this week, we'll understand a little bit more. But we have our action. So let's just go ahead, and in this case, I'm going to use this as a post. So I'm going to do the run post.php. All right, I haven't created that file yet. I'll do that later in the lesson. But we have the run post.php. Yeah, by default, it'll just run this one. Now, I just said this was going to be a post, so the method is going to be post. Again, we'll explain more and more what post and the other one is get that we're going to do in a second, right? We'll explain that all. And now you're just kind of building the HTML to this, right? So you can write the text. Like, if I want to get their name and email, name, and then we use those inputs. So again, you've probably used the inputs before. With JavaScript, it's a nice little way to get input. And then the type, so this shouldn't be new. The type is text. And then this is something that is new, we've not used before, because it doesn't really, I mean, you can use it with JavaScript, but this is what you need to give it a name, right? So I'm going to call this username just to not be confused with name and user and all that kind of fun stuff. So name. And then let's go ahead and close that. And let's add a BR, because these are inline tags. So if I don't add the BR, there's all these boxes are going to be on the same line. And I can show you what that looks like in a second. Now let's ask them for their email. And again, it's an input. So I'm just going to copy all of this so we don't need to type it over and over again. In this case, user email. Again, I'm naming this specifically so you can kind of see the differences as we move along the different pieces. All right, and then finally, This last one, we don't, it's going to be a button, so we don't need to put anything in front of it. We're just going to do input. And this is different than some of you might have used a button tag, which works great with JavaScript. But because this is already going to be in form and we want this to interact with the form, let's just go ahead and add the forms button. So by making type submit, it will make it form, right? And then whatever you type for the value is what you're going to see on the screen, right? So let's go ahead and save this. Go over here, refresh it. And again, you should see the standard generic looking form. We have the name, the input box, email, input box. Again, that's where the BR, otherwise this would all be on the same line without those two BRs added. And then it says post because I made the value post. And you notice I don't have IDs, because IDs are mostly useful for JavaScript, right? You can still use JavaScript to find the name, but if you just think of using JavaScript, again, think of it from simplicity, using JavaScript is easier just to do IDs, and then name is gonna be for these PHP. And again, we'll see what this looks like in a second, but the name is what's gonna get sent. Essentially, it's the variable name that's getting sent across, right? It's the name you're going to use to identify the data so you know how to grab it on the server, right? So this is all on the web page. You click on something, the web page is going to send information to this thing, which is on the server, and then the server is going to do so, right? This is the power of PHP. Now I'm going to go ahead and just copy this, paste it, and then we're going to call this one get, right? And mostly just show you. So you can see I'm updating it to run get and then get. And because you're only able to run one form at a time, right? When you submit this, that's the whole beauty of this all being in that one little form. I can use the same names. So when I run the get, it's gonna do what the get does. And if I click on the post, it's going to run the post. So again, let's save that. Let's look at this form. All right. We have the setup. Now again, you can add whatever inputs you want. You can Google, there's all kinds of different types of inputs you can take. You got file inputs. The key is you're gonna give it a name, you give the input a name, and that's what it's gonna be sent across as, right? So it'll have a name, so you can grab it from the server, and then whatever is typed into this, all right, whatever's typed into this is what gets sent across. And then again, the name is what you do. So this is what makes it a post. This is what makes it get. I forget what the default is. If you don't put any of this, the default action is to run the current page, and I forget if it's get or post. What's the default? But again, it's just for sanity, just always put what method you want to use. All right, so again, I'll save that. Now, well, when we come back, I'll have each of the different gets and post, and we'll kind of talk about how it actually works. So we'll have this on a second page to kind of see how we get the information. So with that, again, this is a form, and you do now want the form tags because if you remember in JavaScript, when you had a form and you clicked on a button, it would try to run it, and basically what it would do is refresh the page, and your JavaScript wouldn't work, right? So if you were taking this class before, you're jumping straight to this, right? If you're using JavaScript and you have a form, unless you make sure to stop, right? There is JavaScript that will stop its process. But if you just build a form, and I've had a lot of students have issues with this, where they're trying to, you know, send some data into JavaScript, and what happens is the page refreshes and then the JavaScript doesn't run because the page refreshes. So again, key difference between when you're using this for JavaScript and when you're using this for PHP, right? So when you see a form online, it is normally designed to be run with PHP, unless, again, there's specific code in the JavaScript that says, hey, don't actually run the form like a form. Just, it looks like a form, but when I do JavaScript, I don't actually normally put the form in there, because you could just put inputs and give them IDs and work with JavaScript. But this is what you need, right? Because everything in this form, if you have an input out here and it has the name and everything's on there, if you have it outside of this form, it's not going to grab this data. So if you type something in here, it's not going to grab it. It has to be inside the form, right? So that's why you kind of have to use the form tag for PHP, is it makes it do that. All right, so that's all I have for this video. We'll do a video for gets, and then we'll do a video for post, so you can kind of see how they look and watch them individually as needed. And then you'll go through the rest of the material for the week. That's all I have for setting up a form. Again, you can Google, watch other things, but that's a good start on what you need to do. See you next time.